So here, behind these trees over here, is the band practicing. And we really want to get an inside scoop of the practice. But there are security guards, so be very careful. We're gonna go now. So come on, join us.
Go.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
No, no, no.
Hey,
whoa, whoa.
No, we need to get in there. No,
we need to get
no,
in there.
No,
we
no,
need
no, 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 no. I have no, candy, no, candy, candy.
Oh, this kid.
Y'all ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, Peter, tell us how you got involved as security for the band.
Well, I was with my nephew, and we were just hanging out at some park, and these hooligans started playing there, and everybody kept jumping up on the stage. So, being a good citizen, I just kind of like pushed everyone off the stage, and well, then they were just like, "Hey, want to be security?" And they handed me this badge. You see this badge? This is my badge. This is my badge.
Okay, it's pretty neat.
Yep.
Oh, he's good. He's good.
Coming down now. We're going to the practice. They're on the stage warming up.
All right, band. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Justin!
Yeah?
Where have you been? We can't play country metal without a cowbell.
What is that?
I was walking around. I kind of had to go to the bathroom a little.
Did you like eat your pudding?
Is that our tapioca pudding?
No.
Is that our pudding?
I don't even like pudding. I'm allergic to pudding.
That looks like tapioca pudding.
I say we just get. We should just start going. I don't eat pudding.
We've been playing for a half hour.
I never have had pudding in my life.
So, we're all very curious. How did you get into cowbelling?
It's a very long story. Well, one day I was at my farm out in Alabama, and a turtle, sweet little turtle, was walking across the street. First thing that popped in my head was cowbell. So that's how I got into it. And on my farm, I have many cows, so I just stole a bunch of cowbells from the cow.
And what's your biggest inspiration in the cowbelling industry?
Oh, definitely Mark, Sterling, Johannes, the lead cowbell in the Beatles.
I see.
Greatest cowbell to ever live.
Wonderful. And if you don't mind, could you please explain to me how it feels to take on all of this hostility from the other band members?
Can you please give me the origin of the word hostility?
So, Pepe, how do you feel the band's going right now?
It's okay.
It's okay. Do you think you're the heart and soul of the band? You're the greatest?
Yeah, I'm definitely the best guitarist.
You're the best guitarist?
Everyone else sucks in this band.
They all suck? Do you think, can we hear a little something from you? That's pretty impressive.
Massage, yeah, get in there.
What's he doing behind you?
He's giving me a massage.
Who is he?
Diego, the band masseuse.
You have a band masseuse?
It's wonderful. It's
Alejandro.
Samuel, what are you doing?
Mom.
Playing in a rock band, you dropped out of college. Your father and I got you into a nice college so you could go to law school and work in the farm. And now you're in a rock band.
I'm sorry, Mom.
Look at your hair. It's just all over the place, and you're wearing a Bob Marley shirt.
Mom, you're embarrassing me.
You're embarrassing me.
Hey,
they call you Thunder?
It's a cool nickname.
We gave you a beautiful name. Samuel's a beautiful name.
So, Thunder, why don't you tell me a little about yourself and your role in the band?
Well, I'm the lead guitarist for the band. I'm basically the heart and soul of the band. I've been called the Jimi Hendrix of my generation. Yeah, we'd be pretty much lost without me.
How do the other band members go?
Oh, they're a mess. I mean, they can't stay on one thing or another. They're always jumping around all over the place. Honestly, I'm carrying this band right now. Like, we'd be nowhere if I wasn't here.
I understand that you're the number one fan of this band. Could you explain where you heard about this band and how you became involved?
Well, one time I was at Chuck E. Cheese, one of my favorite places to be. And I was in the bathroom, you know, just doing what you do in the bathroom. And then one of their songs started playing. And it was just the most amazing thing I've ever heard.
Now, I understand that you've gotten into some legal trouble as you've been following the band around for the past couple years. Has this discouraged you by any means, and could you explain a little more as to what happened?
Well, yeah, I've been arrested a couple times, you know, got some charges for stalking or whatnot. But no, it has not discouraged me at all. I mean, I love the band, and I know that deep down, they love having me as their number one fan. I mean, I'm so nice to them, and like every Christmas, I send them really nice things, like a big bag of all my toenail clippings from over the year. I just send them that every Christmas, and I know that they love it, and they keep them all, and they just really love having me as their fan. I just know it.
I see.
Oh my gosh, it's the band!
Action.
We're about to enter the after party of the band. They've never been observed behind the scenes. Let's check it out. How do you think your relationship is with most people in this band?
Well, I think they would like me, but none of them know my name.
What do you do in your spare time besides manage this band?
Well, since I was about 5, I've been playing piano every day for the past 10 years.
That was really
a song that I wrote and that they took.
Oh, Judas, I heard you're planning on quitting the band. Do you want to explain a little more?
Well, yeah, I mean, when I first, joined the band, I thought I was joining a band of, merry thieves. And then they gave me a drum, and I was kind of, not happy about that.
Really? That's really interesting. So, what do you plan on doing afterwards?
Well, you know, I've decided to join rabbinical school, and I also bought space property, and it was kind of a whole smorgasbord of things that I'm gonna do now that I have a lot of free time.
So, how do you think the band's going to move on after they lose their key drummer?
Well, I'm kind of irreplaceable, you know? Really irreplaceable. They're gonna have a hard time.
I could replace you. I've been playing drums for
Shut up, Kevin!
My name's Keith.
I don't care!
Okay.
So, Alish, how do you feel about the other band members?
They are all...
Spanish.
Son todos geniales. Me encanta la banda. Y espero que el concierto de hoy sea genial.
I don't understand him. How do you feel about the Battle of the Bands concert tonight?
Va a ser genial, creo. Todos los fans van a estar entusiasmados y va a ser el mejor concierto que he dado en toda mi vida.
Do you think you guys are going to win?
What?
Do you guys think you're going to win?
Yeah. Somos los mejores y hemos estado practicando y vamos a ganar seguro.
Can you play a little for us?
Guys, I found this really great drummer on the side of the road. She's selling some squirrels and she's playing for free.
She does.
Whoa. No. You did not just hire my mom.
Oh, yes, she
Tell
did.
Tell me you didn't just.
We have a contract.
Come on, you don't even play the drum.
I most certainly can play the drum.
Come on. Name one song you can play on the drum.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
Oh,
God. Thunder, tell your mom to get out of there.
I'm trying, but.
Am I still calling you Thunder?
Everybody listen up. She's playing whether you like it or not. She's playing for free or else you guys are out. Thanks.
What is this, amateur hour?
Okay, Sam's mom. How do you feel about your son being in a rock band?
I think it's a terrible idea. There's so many better things he could be doing with his life, like going to law school and getting married to some nice girl and making a lot of money for his parents at the firm.
Okay, now that you've joined as the drummer for the band, do you think that's going to have a positive influence on your son's career?
The whole reason I joined the band was so that he'd quit the band and go back to law school.
So, Lily, how's the band to you? Is the band mean a lot to you?
Kinda. Did you know there's a wasp over your head?
That's interesting. Are you nervous about tonight, the Battle of the Bands concert?
No, I'm more nervous about global warming.
So, Mick, as the director, how do you think the project's going?
It's terrible. The people are terrible. Like, it's not going well. The camera crew doesn't know what they're doing. The band is playing bad music. All the people, I could have got cooler people playing my music video. I just got them because they were free.
Ladies up in here tonight, no fighting.
We got the refugees.
No fighting. No fighting. Shakira, Shakira.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. Hey. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama? Bonita. Picasso.
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. Hey. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel it's right. All the attraction, the tension. See, baby, this is perfection.
Hey, girl, I can see your body moving, and it's driving me crazy. And I didn't have the slightest idea until I saw you dancing. Yeah. And when you walk up on the dance floor, nobody can ignore the way you move your body, girl. And everything's so unexpected, the way you right and left it. So you could keep on shaking it.
I never really knew that she could dance like this. Yeah. She make a man wanna speak Spanish. Como se llama?
Shakira, Shakira.
Oh baby, when you talk like that, you make a woman go mad. So be wise and keep on reading the signs of my body. I'm on tonight, you know my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel your joy. Come on, let's go. See us now. Don't you see, baby, I see us perfect. If I know I'm on tonight, my hips don't lie, and I'm starting to feel your joy. All the attraction, attention.
Everyone
going.
Shakira,
Shakira. I can see your body.